Yes, is this a recording?
Hello my friends, here's Bayan. In this video I'm gonna show you guys how to install a hot water tank from A to Z. And like you guys can see, we have it in here. And I'm gonna show you guys how to install a vacuum valve. This thing is a valve in there, and else I'm gonna show you guys how to install an expansion tank. What the expansion tank is an extra tank that is a half is filled with air and half with water. That would balance the pressure inside the hot water tank, because when the hot water warm up, it expands. This should control it. I'm just gonna pull it out in here, that way you guys can see. It's a potential cover. Let's see if we can see. This one is just very much empty. Like, if you look close, you can see like a balloon inside there, kind of a bladder. So once the pressure go, balance the pressure. All we do once we install it, we check the pressure of the water, just like a bike tire. You see that? You just need to put the same pressure as the water. That way it balance out. Usually it come with about 40 psi inside of it, but we might have to increase a bit more. And looks to be brand new from the box and is broken, but doesn't matter. I just use it like that, right? See, this one is installed already, supposed to be something like that. It's broken, it's broken. This one is for this guy, the vacuum valve. Here I have some instruction how to install it. In this case, it's for the hot water tank. We use this example, just keep it on a vertically. Yeah, you gotta install it just vertically. And here on the thread, we're just gonna put some Typhoon tape and extra pipe compound, that way it doesn't leak, and very simple. And here we have an instruction for the expansion tank. So the way they show, very much you can install it on a horizontally, vertically, anyway, and it goes on the cold water. Else the vacuum valve would go on the cold water too. So I'm just gonna take a few minutes to cut my pipe, pre-fit everything, all gonna be on PEX pipe. Once I'm ready, we just go back to this video and I show you the process. Just give me a little bit time, doesn't take long to cut this PEX pipe, and let's rock and roll. Thread compound or pipe compound, it's like the same as a Typhoon tape, but it's on a paste form or liquid form. Usually you don't need both, I just not want to come back for the job site because of leaking. So I'm just gonna tighten up as much as I can with the hand, and then I get the wrench and do it. I just go as much as I can with my hand, and I get the wrench, tie it up as good as I, as much as I can. This one is done. I'm gonna set up in there for now. Next, this guy. One here, guys, once you check the pressure, once you put air inside, you just gotta make sure that you have no pressure from the water going to it. So the water tank gotta be empty when you check the pressure, set it up. So this is pretty much, I'm just gonna set it up right here, something just like that. That way here's for inspection, because this guy, they do rupture inside and they could damage. This one say, I think on the paper they say 6 years warranty, and this is for inspection, right? Is access. This other one is there too, is access for inspection. And now all I have to do is clamp and tighten up these guys together and set up the electrical. The electrical would be probably tomorrow I will do it, because today the time is running out and I have a few other things that I need to do priorities. This is how you guys see. This is my water shutoff on the cold side. If you guys want, can put another water shutoff on the hot side. I have another hot water shutoff here. It's just what I'm gonna do, I show you guys. I will connect these two hot water tanks together and put a water shutoff right inside, just in case if one tank damage, because this is a duplex. So if one tank stop work, we can use to have some hot water cross to the other one on the time being. It's just in case of emergency, but it's not, I hope we not even need to use it, but I'm gonna do it just to make sure we good. The reason that I am not gonna do it right now because I just run out of ring. I just have few ring left from this part. It was enough to do this part, and then later time I would do this. We still have some time working here. Let's go. Let's tighten this guy up. Like you guys can see, I just start my job from up there. So I'm just gonna start to tighten the clamp up that way. Very much is the thing I just can show you on this one. You guys do see. Gonna be all I'm gonna do right now. You see, just leave a little bit loose in there. You see, you have a little bit eight. That way I just grab. What I want to do, I want to grab on this ring. I just leave the ring a little bit back. Like this guy is trying to bite me now. So all I'm gonna do now is just put it in, press it, and once I do that, just take a few minutes and I will have the water back on. So I'm just gonna start from that end, from the where the water come from. I'm gonna tighten up together. So I hope you guys understand this. So cold water comes in, go to the vacuum valve, and then go for the expansion tank and make the turn, warm up inside the hot water tank and go back to the house. This one is the both of them, they would work the same system. So guys, if you have any question how to install this guy, just let me know. I just one more thing, I just gonna show you guys how to connect the electrical. This one is disconnect and this one is connect. That's gonna be just tomorrow I will do it. I just have to do this and run to do other stuff. See you in a bit when I'm doing the electrical. Hello guys, back here to my water tank. So I check the pressure, expansion tank, they have the same pressure as the water. So now I'm gonna connect the electrical. This one was already connected to the water there, so it's just go back to the panel. This one here I'm gonna connect with this wire that I have run. I just have this conduit in here to protect the wire a bit. This I have a 12-3 wire, but what I gonna be use the neutral I'm not gonna use. I just gonna use these two wires because I was just looking at the instructions in here how to connect it, and I just need the two wires. So the white wire I'm just gonna put aside. Oh, before I gonna check, I know the power is off, but I just gonna check the brake again, make sure it is 100% off. Very much set up. I just gonna this wire in there, pass it through, make sure everything is secure. So this white wire I just gonna isolate it and put it aside. The connection for the ground wire is right there, and these two are gonna connect as the instruction goes. So guys, this is a, you guys can see here, 12 gauge wire, and we have two hot ends. Once we turn on the power, gonna be two hot ends. The instruction, I just check it right there. Like you guys can see, one phase power on goes one wire in there, the other one in here. So it's just what I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna go to number one. Make sure it is secure in there. Should be okay. It goes right there somewhere. So I'm gonna fire up both of this. I'm just gonna cut this guy a little bit shorter. Not to be on the way. This one here, not gonna be using it. There we go. Okay, for now I'm just gonna leave it like that, not gonna put the cover on yet. What I'm gonna do next, I'm gonna just open up of the water from both of them, make sure they are full with water, remove the air, and we go from there. I did not this pipe in here, I need to screw it to the side of the tank to make sure it is straight, and I'm gonna just cut it a little bit higher, that way the water just go out to the drain in there. I'm gonna cut that drain level with the ground while the tank is filling in with the water, and then I do those things. And then we let it fill in, and then we open some faucet, let the air run out. Here guys, I'm just gonna open this guy up to release some pressure from the air, because the tank is full of air, you guys can see on it. All we gotta do, we gotta wait until there's no air in the system. Then we make sure the tank is full, and then we turn on the power. Just gonna leave it there. go up and run. You guys can see this one, it's just some air inside. Make sure the air is all out. We really not want to air the system, and then I'm gonna go inside the house on the last faucet and I'm just gonna drain some water. This one looks very good. Oops. You guys can see the water there just coming good. Yeah guys, tank looks to be full of water, both of them, so I'm just gonna flip on the breaker and we see the result. Like you guys can see, my heater is working good, the hot water heater. Nice and warm water. So I'm just gonna close this in half. Wow, really hot. Didn't take very long. And it's the way to go, guys. Let me turn this thing off. Hello my friends, yes, the hot water tanks, they are working great, all running good. Let me know if you have any questions. So in this video we did the expansion tank, we connect the hot and cold water, we install the electrical for the hot water tank. So if you have any question, just let me know. Alright, thank you very much and see you on the next one.